欢迎收看盲观华尔街视角。今天大家关注的重头消息就是由于美军撤军，所以现在呢阿富汗的局势是转变的非常的迅速。那我们还是从投资人的角度来看这个问题。如果说阿富汗现在局势迅速转变之后，投资人应该如何看待目前这个政局的变化？会不会因此而增加市场心态的不稳定，造成对市场的大幅震荡呢？那么今天就是 Sam Stovall， 我们的专家，首先从这个方面为我们进行分析。
I think actually that military or terrorist shocks in history have historically impacted headlines more than bottom lines, since the effect typically dissipated quickly as investors concluded that it would really not have a material impact on the global economy.
另外，我们还回忆了。就当年呢，就是越战时期呢，是这个美军从越南撤离西贡之后，那么美国的股票市场有什么直接的反应呢？
In the 1 to 3 months after the fall of Saigon on April 30th of 1975, the S&P 500 gained 4.5% and 2% the 1 and 3 months after.So it was positive, and not surprisingly, the aerospace and defense sub-industry did very well, up 15.5% 1 month later, and then 26% 3 months later. So basically, it showed that there probably was an investor interest into those areas that might benefit from America's embarrassment by losing the control of South Vietnam.
另外，我们记得奥巴马总统当年从伊拉克撤军 ，ISIS 恐怖组织诞生。那这次拜登从阿富汗撤军，会不会又有新的恐怖组织诞生？那美国投资人会不会因为惧怕恐袭而不敢再投资，或者引发市场的信心的大幅下降，导致大幅波动呢？
I don't think that investors will be selling the market in general, worrying that there will be some sort of terrorist activities going on, but rather it would be more specific towards sub-industries that would benefit from increase in cyber warfare in your traditional aerospace and defense and armaments, etc. So anything that could help protect the U.S. from these kind of terrorist activities will probably see a lot of investor attention, but I don't think it's going to go into reverse and cause investors to move out of the stock market.
在1956年时，为了控制苏伊士运河的控制权，以色列、英国和法国联合与埃及开战。后来美国和苏联呢是进行了这个干预，而且美国还威胁英国立即停火，否则的话就会抛售英镑为主导货币的英国的财政债券。所以呢，在多方面的压力之下，这个战争就不了了之了。但是后果是英国就此失去了他们在全世界的这个统治和作为殖民主的这样一个影响势力。那么也有专家就把这次阿富汗撤军导致的混乱局面比喻成像当时年苏伊士运河的状况，那是不是会就此结束美国在国际市场上从政治、经济与金融市场方面的独统的影响力呢？主要是因为失去了信誉力，而且为美国提供服务的民众生命都受到了这么大的威胁。所以有的专家还提出，可能人们今后会把信心逐渐地转向不断崛起的中国，从此之后世界的政治布局以及金融市场的布局要重新安排。当然，以下是 Sam Stovall， 他认为目前的事件最起码对美国的美债美元的影响。
Investors buy treasuries because they are looking for a secure, transparent place in which to park their money. Because ofthe decision by the U.S. to no longer be involved with Afghanistan after 20 years has nothing to do with the Treasury and the U.S.'s ability to pay back its loans. So I think it has absolutely nothing to do with the change in the yield on the 10-year note and whether investors will be interested in investing in U.S. Treasuries going forward.
好，阿富汗事件引发的后续的对金融市场和投资界的影响，当然我们还有待观察。那以上就是今天的内容，谢谢您的收看，我们下次再见。